Yes, guys, David here. Welcome to another BTECT. This one's sponsored by Direct Mobiles. Go and check out the best mobile deals at directmobiles.co.uk. I think that this year we are going to see a lot of very good mid-range devices, and that's mainly thanks to Qualcomm and the release of the Snapdragon 765G, which is an upper mid-range processing chipset that still enables 5G on devices, but for a much more affordable price than the Snapdragon 865. It's enabling manufacturers to produce good specs and, by all account, high-end phones while still keeping the price below £1,000. The recent release from Nokia is a good example of this. Their 8.3 is a flagship phone and it comes in at around about £700 while still giving us 5G connectivity and great camera performance. LG have turned some heads recently with the reveal of their forthcoming device, the LG Velvet. A 5G phone with gorgeous styling, this one really does offer something different, considering that recently all we've seen from many of the manufacturers is this rectangular camera bump that takes up a good portion of that back panel. The styling here is much more subtle yet distinctive, with the camera lenses resembling droplets of water, reducing in size as it comes down, the smallest one being the flash. The screen ratio of 20.5:9 gives it a slender appearance, and it does have kind of sharp corners, giving it a boxy style resembling the Galaxy Note series. Notice how the corners of the frame overlap onto the back panel, which I think is a nice touch. LG mentioned their 3D arc design, which means that the back panel has the same curve as the front glass, giving it symmetry, which LG say gives it a more natural feel in the hand. The colours available will be Aurora White, Aurora Grey, Aurora Green and Illusion Sunset. To me, all of these design features do add up to give it a very distinctive and quite a quirky look. Despite this device not scheduled to be announced until the 7th of May, LG have already released a lot of information about it. We know it's going to be quite a big device, with a water drop notched, curved 6.8-inch Full HD Plus OLED display, and as I mentioned before, with that 20.5:9 aspect ratio. 8GB of RAM and 128GB of expandable storage will be present, along with the new Snapdragon 765G, all of which will draw power from a 4,300mAh battery, which supports wired fast charging and 10W wireless charging. The renders show off a headphone jack, which do seem to be making a comeback this year in the higher spec phones, which is great if you ask me. We also have stereo speakers. That interesting camera array will house a 48-megapixel sensor, which, like many other high-megapixel smartphone cameras, will use pixel binning to give you a 12-megapixel shot. There'll also be an 8-megapixel ultra-wide and a 5-megapixel depth sensor. Around the front, we will have a 16-megapixel selfie camera. The presence of that water drop style notch means we probably won't see any air motion gesture control system that we have seen in the LG G8, which for a lot of people isn't really a big deal, me included. But I think the feature that will make the LG Velvet the most appealing will be that chipset. This new chip from Qualcomm gives manufacturers the opportunity to build a powerful 5G phone and be able to offer it with attractive or realistic pricing. It wasn't that long ago when 700 to 800 quid was the very top end for a flagship phone. But as the technology has evolved and more components get added to devices, that upper limit has pretty much doubled or even tripled if you include phones like the Huawei Mate XS. The 765G is a fast, power-efficient 7-nanometer chip with 8 cores divided into 2 clusters and a max core speed of 2.4 GHz. This chip should also make the Velvet a very good choice for gaming, as the chip is optimized with a higher clock speed than the normal Snapdragon 765 and has support for additional software features like Game Smoother, Game Fast Loader and Game Network Latency Manager. Overall, I think that the specs are very good, and with the Velvet rebranding and really nice styling, I think that this one could put LG back on a lot of people's radar. It covers all bases with its 5G connectivity, it should have a good camera with its 48 megapixel sensor and the Snapdragon 765G ISP, a nice big battery working with that 765, which theoretically will be more power efficient than the 865, good looks as well, which, let's be honest, probably sells more phones than any of the other specs that I've mentioned, but I really do think that it depends on the price. That's probably the one thing that LG haven't let slip just yet, which really isn't a good sign, but we'll just have to wait until the 7th of May to find that one out. My best guess is that it will be between £600 and £700. Let me know how much you would pay for this phone in the comments below, and once it does get announced, make sure you check out the Direct Mobiles website for the best possible deals on this or any other phone. Direct Mobiles lets you compare all of the networks to find the best possible price. Plus, they have over 24 years of award-winning customer service, so you really are in good hands. Their link is in the description below, or just search directmobiles.co.uk. I really like the look of the Velvet, definitely looks promising. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Also, you can follow me on social media. I'm David, this is BTECT.